Okay, so let's discuss the chronology of Israel Palestine, which will help you to understand, which will consolidate your understanding of this region in a better way. Okay, India-Israel relationship. India-Israel, the phases of India-Israel totally dependent on this thing that how Israel-Palestine relationship evolved. So the name of the land is Palestine, and Jews were looking forward for what? Jewish Palestine, name Israel. So two Palestines, their objective was to create two Palestine, one for Jews, one for Arabs. Okay, Shubham. So Jews and Arabs both were living under Ottoman Empire created by Turks. Majority of the Turks follower of Islam, majority of the Arabs follower of Islam. Okay. So once the territory was disintegrated from Ottoman, who were living in these territories? Majority Arabs, minority Jews. And Jews supported whom? Britain during the First World War. Allied powers. And Allied promised them their own nation state. So Jews realized that Britain is in favor of creation of a state of our own. So Arabs lived under whom? British colonialism. Okay, that's why they were inclined more towards whom? Soviet during Cold War. And West Brit, and that's why US and West, they were well aware of this. Oil is under the control of Arab states. And their objective was to have a military presence here. Okay, when Hitler started genocide of Jews started entering into which region? Palestine, which was under the control of whom? Britain. And Britain allowed the entry of Jews into Palestine, resisted by whom? Arabs. By 1940, the demography of this territory totally changed. Half of the population was of Jews and half were Arabs by 1940. And the demand for an independent Jewish Palestine increased. Britain proposed one state solution, rejected by Jews. The way they proposed one state solution here in South Asia, rejected by a league. Okay, to take care of the interest of Muslims within a united India. But League was against this. League was adamant for partition on the name of religion. But League was against the partition of Palestine on the name of religion. The stand of Indian National Congress was consistent. No partition on the name of religion and ethnicity. Different religions can live within a state, within a political territory. Different ethnicities, religions can live peacefully. Okay, unity in diversity. So INC was consistent with its stand, right? The chronology of Israel Palestine, right? Creation of Israel in 1948. Right, World War One. Created. Right, the World War One. Created a sense of nationalism world over. And even Jews were inspired to have their own nation state. They were inspired to have their own nation state. This led to the establishment of World Zionist Organization, Zion, Z-I-O-N-I-S-T. They called this land as Land of Zion. Who? Jews. Their holy land. World Zionist Organization, which started as a political movement. To take Jews from Europe to Zion, their holy land. So, during the World War, one Jews were supporting whom? The Allied. Okay, that's why Hitler, after the end of First World War, when came to power, say, so Hitler took the stand, Jews should live where? In their holy land. They do not have any place in Germany. They are anti-nationalists. It is because of them we defeated badly. We faced humiliation. Germany, supreme race, no one can defeat us. Okay, it is because the conspiracy of Jews, we were defeated. Send them. So genocide of Jews were justified by Nazis. I hope now you can understand and you can relate the things. ठीक है ना, chronology clear होनी चाहिए, right? In 1917, so still war was going on. In 1917, British government under Balfour Declaration, BALFOURD. Announced support for the establishment of a nation state for the Jewish people within Palestine. Nation state for the Jewish people within Palestine. In bracket, at that time, the part of Ottoman Empire with a small minority Jewish population. With a small minority Jewish population. So British promised them, we'll help you, okay, under Balfour Declaration to bring Jews towards their side. Next point. After the end of World War I, the mandate of Palestine means political control, the mandate of Palestine. Came under British rule. So revolutionaries of India were right that these are imperial powers who are fighting for the interest, for their own interest. they will not going to give us independence. Okay. In fact, they acquire the control over more territories. Imperialism expanded in the world, and harsh laws within India after the First World War, Rowlatt Act, and Jallianwala Bagh took place. Okay, so revolutionaries were right in their prediction. The mandate of Palestine came under British rule, and this increased the influx of Jews within Palestine. Which was opposed by Arabs. Opposed by Arab. Next point. The Jewish Holocaust or genocide. By Germany created or by Nazi Germany created a wave of sympathy for the Jews. Created a wave of sympathy for the Jews. US government pressurized the British. So by that time, strong Jewish lobby was there in US. Okay. Britain, ally of US during the Second World War. So pressure from US to Britain, political control of Palestine under the control of Britain. So US pressurized the government of Britain to allow the entry of European Jews into Palestine. Thus, Nazi persecution resulted in high influx of Jews into Palestine. And by 1940, half of the population of Palestine became Jewish. Okay, Shubham. So Arabs believe these lands belong to us. Jews claim these belongs to us. Reason for hatred. Now Jerusalem, land of three religion. Okay, the claim that all three are Abrahamic religion. That all three emerged from where? Jerusalem. Three religion: Christianity, Islam, and Judaism. So all three Christians, Jews, and Muslims have their claim over Jerusalem. Okay. In continuation, became Jewish, and with the change of you have written this line with the change of democracy, with the change in demography, the demand of Israel as a separate state grew. आदित्य मुझे भी नहीं पता इसका मतलब. ये तो रिलीजियस प्रीचर बताएगा ना आपको. ओके, व्हाट वी मीन बाय अब्राहमिक मींस द बिलीव दैट ऑल थ्री इमर्ज फ्रॉम अब्राहम. इट इज समवन समथिंग लाइक यू आर आस्किंग सर हु वाज राम. ओके, समवन हु डज नॉट हैव एनी understanding about the Hindu culture asking, sir, who was the father of Ram or Dashrath Kaun? That is something like this. These questions are like this. Okay. With the change in demography of Palestine, the demand of Israel as a separate state grew. Next point. Right. Britain proposed a two-state solution. Which was rejected by Arabs. So India was also against the partition, brought India and Arabs on the same lines. Okay. Indian National Congress and the Arab parties. So opinion of Gandhi and Nehru was what? No partition on the name of a religion. So before independence, our foreign policy started taking the shape. Okay. Because of the views of Gandhi itself. But according to the right wingers, when we accepted partition here, we could have changed our foreign policy according to the need of the hour. Rather than sticking to the earlier opinion, we could have brought the requisite change as Arabs started supporting whom? Pakistan on the issue of Kashmir. And Israel always stood with India, rock solid with India. So we should have also made our priorities clear. We should have clear our stand and would have told Arab world clearly that our support is not unconditional. If you want Indian support, you need to understand India's sensitivities over Kashmir. It can't be unconditional support to you. Okay. As Arab world always supported Pakistan during Indo-Pakistan war, while Israel stood with India, and we always supported Arabs in Israel-Arab war. Okay, right. So that's why the blame on Congress, that the Congress policy was driven more because of the domestic compulsion. Okay, to appease Indian Muslims. That's why according to the right wingers, we are not communal. You are anti-nationalist. You have always played with the interest of the nation to fetch votes. It is you who have played a vote bank politics in India since independence. It is you who have hurted the integration of Muslims with India. How come the Muslims of India will have anything to do with the Muslims of West Asia? Okay, so it is your vote bank politics which has hurted the interest of the nation. So we are not communal. You are anti-national. This is the stand of right wingers. Okay, minority appeasement done by Congress in India since independence. Right. So two-state solution rejected by Arabs. Then Britain proposed one-state solution, which was rejected by Jews. The way one-state solution rejected by League in South Asia. So remarkable similarity, the way geopolitics has unfolded in both the regions, you will come to know. Remarkable similarity. The way Indo-Pakistan relationship has evolved, the way Israel-Palestine relationship has evolved. Next point. In 1948, Britain demanded UN help. So again, Britain was ready to leave its subject at their own fate, just was desperate for withdrawal. Britain demanded UN help. As Britain was not able to bear the high cost of maintaining peace within this region. And UN voted in favor of two-state solution. UN voted in favor of two-state solution. And on 14th May 1948, Jewish Palestine was established. And Israel was born. So Jewish Palestine, Arab Palestine. These are two Palestines. Jewish Palestine is known as Israel. So these territories were given to Jews. And the green one given to whom? Arabs. So Israel, Palestine for Arabs. So these territories given to Arabs. This is known as Gaza Strip. And this is known as West Bank. Okay. So Gaza is in the west, west is in east. Gaza Strip, West Bank. Now, Jews and Arabs were living everywhere within Palestine. So this started what? A large-scale migration here too. The way we saw in India, a Jewish land for Jews. So Jews can enter. So Jews started entering where? Within Israel. And Arabs started going where? To Palestine. Now, other than this, Arabs never accepted this partition. Arabs were not ready to leave their homes. Okay. Also, Israel declared itself as a secular state, the way India did. Secular democracy. So Israel said even Arabs can live within Israel. They will are going to have citizenship from Israel only. Will not going to use violence against them. It's just they should not support violence against the state. Till date, many Arabs are living within the state of Israel. Okay, it's not in Israel, all are Jews. There are Arabs too within Israel. Clear? So Israel declared itself as a secular democratic state and India declared itself as a secular democratic state. So Israel always looked towards India as what? A natural ally. Okay, but so both opinion prevails that one thing, Indian policy towards Israel was driven more because of domestic compulsion. And earlier also I told you 2 R's can't drive your foreign policy. If region and religion will determine your national interest, it will going to impact what? The core interest of the state. You cannot drive your foreign policy because of domestic compulsions. Regional interests are different. National interests are different. So region and religion can't be the determinants of foreign policy. Okay. We need to have objectivity in our national interest. So Jewish Palestine was established and Israel was born and UN decided that Jerusalem will be a, because both parties laid down their claims over it. And UN decided that Jerusalem will be a UN-administered territory. A UN-administered territory. Just after its creation, Israel was attacked by Arab states. When I'm saying Arab states, what you have understood from this, that Israel was attacked by Arab states. These Arab states, who all attacked? So the joint forces of Syria, Jordan, Lebanon, Egypt, they all attacked Israel, never accepted the creation of a Jewish state. Arabs laid down their claim over these territories. So Arab states means Syria, Jordan, Lebanon, Iraq, Egypt, all attacked Israel. And who used to be seen as the leader of Arab world? Egypt. seen as leader, Egypt. So in such a hostile environment, Israel has survived. Okay. In such a hostile environment, Israel has survived. That's why the saying goes, lot of political instability outside Israel, while lot of stability within Israel. The biggest reason is what? The Israeli leadership objectify their national interest. And they have never played with their national interest. Okay. You will come to know how they have defeated the Arabs in their game plan, because they are surrounded by the Arab world, but still they are able to survive and able to defeat the Arab world. Right now, the cause of Palestine is losing. So Arab, there is a lot of drift within the Arab world. Since Abraham Accord, Palestine, the issue of Palestine is losing its prominence among the Arab world itself, as they have failed to defeat the Israel and they have realized this. Okay, the reason being because the leadership of Jews objectify their national interest and they have never played with their national interest. Okay, right. Attacked by the Arab state. The result of the war was three-fourth of the Palestine was captured by Israel. So first Arab-Israel war, Palestinians lose their territory. Israel expanded. 3/4 of the Palestine came under the control of Israel, was captured by Israel. Also, Israel captured West Jerusalem. Israel captured West Jerusalem. While Jordan acquires the control over West Bank and East Jerusalem. Thus, after the first war, it was Arabs, or it was Arab Palestinians. Who found themselves living as refugees. So they became refugees on their own land, who found themselves living as refugees either in Israel or in Jordan. So India fought the war with Pakistan just after independence. Israel supported India on the issue of Kashmir. Even in UN, India voted against the creation of Israel in UN. It's written in your booklet. So India voted against the creation of Israel in UN. And in this first war, India supported whom? Arabs. Okay. That Israel has been created out because of Israel. The state has been come out of violence. So we are not supporting the creation of the state of Israel. Okay. It has not been created peacefully. Through violence, it has been created. So India supported Arab world. Okay. Right. After the war of 1948, the war of 1948, गमाल अब्दुल नासिर हुसैन। नासिर हुसैन टुक द पॉलिटिकल कंट्रोल ऑफ इजिप्ट। In 1952, so Nasser, a nationalist socialist leader who stood for the unity of Arab world. Okay, these were the growing years of Saddam Hussein. So he used to look towards Nasser as a Arab nationalist, a hero. Okay, so for him, Nasser was a hero who stood for the unity of Arab world. Right. And Nasser wanted to reduce the presence and influence of British in Suez. Influence of British in Suez. He nationalized the Suez Canal. He nationalized the Suez Canal, which led to the War of 1956. Known as Suez Crisis. When the British, French, and the Israeli forces attacked Egypt. So again in 1956, Nasser, closer to Arab world, closer to India, Nasser, one of the founding member of NAM, okay, Arab unity, Afro-Asian unity. So during 56, we criticize whom? Israel. Okay. For showing aggression against Egypt. British, French, and Israeli forces attacked Egypt. Right. The Suez War led to the end of the influence of Britain in this region. So presence of British and French forces in this region was in the interest of Israel. But as now the influence of British is about to end, what Israel did after in this war, Israel acquired the political control over Sinai Peninsula too. So that it can keep Egypt away from itself as a buffer against Egypt. Okay. Right. Suez led to the end of the influence of British in Suez, but Israel captured Sinai Peninsula. Israel captured Sinai Peninsula as a buffer against Egypt. Next paragraph, next bullet point, in 1964, Arab world established PLO, Palestinian Liberation Organization. India is one of the first country to give recognition to PLO later, once he changed its way from violence to non-violence. We'll tell you. So Arab world established PLO, Palestinian Liberation Organization, with the objective. To eliminate Israel from West Asia. Okay. Objective to eliminate. So their trust was on violent means earlier. So now PLO was created, right? And in 1967, Arab world again attacked Israel, known as Second Arab-Israel War. 65, we fought with Pakistan. Okay. Second Arab-Israel War, also known as Six-Day War. Israel ended the war within 6 days. After the war, Israel acquired Gaza Strip. Golan Heights, and West Bank. So war started by Arabs, ended by Israel. Israel acquired Gaza Strip, West Bank from Jordan, and also captured Golan Heights from Syria. Till that time, it was under the control of Syria. As I said, Syria was planning to divert the waters which were going to Israel. So existential threat for Israel. So Israel also acquired Golan too. Okay, from Syria. So every inch of this region, you can see every inch came under the control of whom? Israel. 65 war, we fought with Pakistan. We gave the territories back under Tashkent Agreement. Okay, so that's how this notion got strengthened. India is a soft state, while Israel aggressively protected its interest. Okay, right after the war, Arabs took the matter to UN. And demanded that Israel should vacate these territories and hold borders as existed before the outbreak of the war of 1967. Israel refused. We have acquired these territories through blood. You can't expect us to give you back just like that. You will keep using hostility and violence against Jews and expect from Jews to give you the territories back. Israel refused. And India criticized whom in UN? Israel. For acquiring the territories through violence and aggression. Okay, Israel said we are not India. So Israel refused openly. Right. A more radical faction was emerged within Palestine, that is Fatah or Fateh. in Arabic victory. Fatah faction. A more radical faction emerged in Palestine, that is Fatah. In 1969, under the leadership of Yasser Arafat, might be few of you are familiar with the name of this leader, Yasser Arafat. Are you? No. Not aware with the name of this leader, Arafat. So, when he started his political career, his trust was on violent means. So, created a violent outfit with the name Fatah, again, to fight a war with Israel. In his later years, he realized violence is not the solution. We can't acquire our objectives through violence. Agreed for two-state solution, and in his later years, worked a lot for the Israel-Palestine. Worked a lot for Israel Arab peace. Okay, for Israel Arab peace, and emphasized a lot for a two-state solution. Okay, so a tall Arab leader, Yasser Arafat, and Fatah faction vowed. They vowed to eliminate Israel through armed struggle. Armed struggle. And in 1973, Arab world again attacked Israel. Third Arab-Israel war. 71 we fought. After the war of 71, military of Pakistan got the lesson that we cannot attain our political objectives through a direct military conflict. The same realization got hit to Arabs after fighting this war. So, remarkable similarity, the way politics has unfolded in both the regions. You can see that. Okay. So, right. Arab world again attacked Israel, known as Third Arab-Israel War, also known as Yom Kippur War. Yom Kippur, Y-O-M. Yom Kippur, a Jewish festival. Okay, a Jewish festival. Nationwide celebrations. It's a kind of national festival in Israel. So, Arab world thought this is the best time to take these territories back. Military deployment all-time low along the borders. Okay, country was busy in national celebrations. So they decided to attack during this particular festival, that is Yom Kippur. But their plan got leaked somehow. And Israel was able to protect every inch of the territory which was under their control. So Arab world again defeated badly. And they realized we can't attain political victory through a direct military conflict. The way Pakistan realized. Dynamics change after 1989, Soviet left in this region, and Pakistan started looking forward towards what? Bleeding India through thousand cuts, proxy war. Similar was the objective or strategy adopted by the Arab Palestinians later. Acquire political victory through proxy war. Okay, so start of proxy war. Pakistan decided before we'll start proxy war, we should have nuclear weapon in our hand so that India should not retaliate with a full-scale military operation against us. Yes, similar is the aspiration of the Palestinians to have a nuclear weapon in their hand. And who could have given them the nuclear weapon? You will come to know Saddam Hussein. And now the threat is Iran can do that. That's why Israel can't see Iran being a nuclear weapons state. Right. The Arab world again defeated. And Israel was able to protect every inch of the territory which was under its control. So, era of wars ended. Now, the way Shimla Agreement, prospects of peace, here also started the peace process. We'll fight for 100 years, then we'll realize the futility of shooting on each other. Okay. And Israel was able to protect every inch of the territory. Right. After the war, Fatah faction merged with PLO. And Arab leadership agreed for peace process with Israel. Now they got agreed. Jab sab kuch chala gaya, they got agreed for peace process with Israel. And demanded the creation of Arab Palestine within Gaza Strip and West Bank, which was earlier given to them under the UN plan. Creation of Arab Palestine, already which was given to them way back in 47, 71 onwards, they came up with a similar demand of Arab Palestine in Gaza and West Bank. And their demand is not yet fulfilled. Those are 21 mein aa gaye hain. Okay. They are still demanding for the same. At present, what is the present situation? There is no West Bank as such which has left, because already more than 70% of the West Bank is under the control of Israel, which are seen by Arabs. Sorry. So right now, this is the present situation of West Bank. Okay, so Jewish settlements are there within West Bank, which are seen as what? Illegal settlements by whom? Arabs and India too. And India supports the demand of Arabs towards the creation of Arab Palestine in Gaza and West Bank. But do you think Israel will going to take its... where Israel will going to send the Jews which are settled in these territories? Israel will not going to do that. Okay, so for many scholars, analysts, thinkers, they have started looking. So what can be the possible solution for this issue then? So again, they have started, the talks have started in this direction that again, both should start looking towards for what? One state solution, where Arabs and Jews living within the state of Israel. So now it is not possible to have even a two-state solution. Two-state solution is not possible anymore. Only possibility which we are left with is one-state solution. And Arabs need to learn to live with Jews. And the cause of Palestine is losing the importance within the Arab world. Okay. Right. And Arabs demanded the creation of Arab Palestine in Gaza and West Bank, with East Jerusalem under their control. This is their demand. With East Jerusalem under their control. Right. In 1978, US invited Arab states for peace talks. At Camp David, known as Camp David Accord. PLO rejected. To participate in these talks, refused to accept US as a mediator. While Egypt accepted this accord, the Arab world was shocked, okay? That the leader of the Arab world is ready to negotiate peace with whom? Jews. And till date, India was not ready to recognize Israel or not ready to start. Sunlo, in 1978, Egypt started diplomatic ties with Israel, allowed Israel to have its embassy within Egypt. Start of full-scale diplomatic ties between Egypt and Israel. So the leader of Arab world is ready to negotiate peace. While India allowed Israel to have its embassy in India after 90s, 95 mein Israel ki embassy aayi hai. We recognized PLO way back in 80s, but we allowed Israel to have its embassy in India after 90s, despite the leader of Arab world, Egypt, started full-scale diplomatic ties from 78 itself. That's why we say India tried to look more Arab than Arabs themselves. Okay? Right. While Egypt accepted this accord, which led to the signing of Egypt-Israel Peace Treaty. Under this treaty, Egypt agreed to not use violence or support violence against Israel. Not use violence and support violence against Israel. So these assurances were given to Israel by the state of Egypt. So as you are ready to sign peace with us, Israel agreed to vacate Sinai. Israel agreed to vacate Sinai Peninsula. I don't need a buffer anymore. Israel agreed to vacate Sinai. And Israel agreed to give more autonomy to the Arab Palestinians in Gaza and West Bank. Not control, not independence. In fact, only autonomy. Give more autonomy to Arabs in Gaza and West Bank. This accord was criticized by Arab world and PLO. So unity of Arab world shattered. Criticized by Arab world and PLO. Accord took place which year? 78. Near about this time period, another major geopolitical event took place in West Asia. What was that?
What was Iranian that? Revolution.
Very good. Iranian Revolution. Okay. So one side Iranian Revolution, fundamentalist came to power, anti-Jews. Listen very carefully. And meanwhile, Iran-Iraq war started, right? Saddam Hussein. He was getting the support from whom? West. To defeat whom? Shias. Support from Saudi too. To defeat Shias. But Arab signed, Egypt signed the peace deal with whom? With Israel. But Saddam, a strong or a nationalist or a Sunni nationalist Arab leader too? Yes. And this was the time when Saddam decided to project himself as a leader of Arab world and started supporting whom? Arabs in their war against whom? Israel. So Saddam invaded Kuwait. Saddam conducted genocide against Kurds. And Saddam started supporting whom? The freedom struggle of Arabs against Israel, against imperialism. So Saddam stood for the unity of Arab world. That's why for many Arabs, Saddam was a nationalist, not a terrorist. Samajh gaye? Right. In conclusion, as the frustration among the Palestinians increased, this led to the formation of Hamas. Hamas ban gaya group. 1987. 88-9 Iraq was engaged in a war with Iran. Okay. And later on started supporting whom? Hamas. Hamas follower of the ideology of Wahhabism. anti-Jews will eliminate Israel. Okay, from these, will eliminate every Jew from West Asia. Formation of Hamas. Okay, and Hamas pledged to eliminate every Jew from West Asia. And Hamas started proxy war against Israel. So, अब दो factions हो गए Arab Palestinians के ही, Hamas and PLO. So, there were two factions among the Arab Palestinian. One was PLO, second Hamas. PLO agreed for what? A two-state solution, creation of Palestine in Gaza and West Bank. Hamas still adamant on what? Elimination of Israel. Only one state, only belong land, all thing belongs to whom? Arabs. Okay. So more national, which leadership will going to project them as more nationalist? Hamas leadership. Okay. Moderate leadership. So we can now from here a demarcation, that is PLO is a moderate leadership of Arab Palestinian, while Hamas is a extremist organization of Arab Palestinians. Right. In 1991, US again invited Arab world. And Israel for peace talks at Madrid, known as Madrid peace talks. End of Cold War, 91, Madrid peace talks, which was again rejected by PLO. However, accepted by Syria and Jordan. So unity was further shattered. Pressure built on India to start diplomatic ties with Israel. End of Cold War. We were willing to improve our ties with US and West. So pressure was there. Start diplomatic ties with Israel too. Okay. A peace treaty was signed between Israel and Jordan. So when we say peace treaty, it means commitment not to use violence and support violence. Second, we'll have embassies in each other country. So start of diplomatic ties. This is what we mean by peace treaty. Okay, so peace treaty was signed between Israel and Jordan. While Syria and Israel failed to sign any peace treaty, and the issue of Golan is still disputed. So you can see from the map also, Israel never acquired anything from Jordan. So there was no as such. So it was easy for Israel and Jordan to sign a peace deal because not an inch of territory of Jordan was under the control of Israel. But Syria has its claim over Golan. Israel only acquired West Bank, which was never belongs to Jordan. So it was easy to have a peace deal between the two, and the deal took place while Israel and Syria failed to sign a peace deal, and still Golan is disputed. Okay, for Arabs, Golan belongs to them. It should be under the control of Syria. Israel can't allow them to have a control over Golan because water security is a concern for Israel, and Arabs have hostility against Jews. This is the reason. And last year, Trump accepted the claim of Israel over Golan. And this statement of term was criticized by the Arab world. Sinai is under Egypt. Sinai Peninsula belongs to Egypt now, Rui? Right, in continuation. In 1993, Oslo Accord took place. Very important for all of you to know. Oslo Accord. Oslo, capital of? सोचना पड़ रहा है, इतना सोचना पड़ रहा है, आ गया याद। चलो, फिनलैंड की कैपिटल क्या है? हेलसिंकी। एंड स्वीडन, स्टॉकहोम। दीज वाई दीज स्कैंडिनेवियन स्टेट्स आर सीन एज, आपको बता रहा हूं बिकॉज अगेन जीएस में इंपॉर्टेंट नहीं है, पॉल साइंस ऑप्शन स्टूडेंट्स को बताना चाहिए। These Scandinavian countries are seen as politically neutral. Okay, recently, Houthis and the Yemen government agreed to sit for peace talks in one of the Scandinavian states because these states are seen as politically neutral. They do not have any geopolitical ambitions. They are fine living, they are fine. Okay, so they are fine. Rather than saying they are not under the policy of isolation, but they do not nurture any geopolitical ambitions too. So by and large, these Scandinavian states are seen as politically neutral in world politics. Okay, so whenever they have offered to sit as a mediator, parties by and large have agreed to accept these states as mediators. Okay, so Oslo Peace Accord took place, known as Land for Peace Proposal. Land for Peace Proposal. And it was signed between Israel and PLO. So Indian government gave a recognition to the leadership of PLO. Was one of the first country, one of the first few who gave recognition to PLO. PLO have its embassy in India much before the embassy of Israel in India. Okay, now this time, this accord took place between whom? Israel and PLO. Means government of Israel agreed to give recognition to whom? PLO leadership. They agreed to give recognition to whom? PLO leadership. Right. Where PLO accepted the existence of Israel. And Israel agreed for phased withdrawal, this time not autonomy, we are ready for withdrawal, agreed for phased withdrawal from Gaza and West Bank. And Israel agreed to transfer political power in the hands of PLO leadership. So who represents Palestine in UN, as now Palestine is having an observer status in UN? Which leadership? PLO leadership. So PLO is seen as a legitimate political entity to govern the territory of Palestine. Okay. Political power in the hands of PLO leadership. Who is the present president of PLO, Ria? Josna, who is the president of PLO? Priya? Shubham? Abhishek? Nahin. Kabhi socha PLO ka bhi koi president hai? Sakshi? Nitin Yahu? Rui? Thank God you are not in front of me. Nitin Yahu is the prime minister of Israel, not the president of PLO. He's a prime minister of Israel. President of PLO, I'm asking. Arafat earlier. Presently, whom? That's why I said Arafat in his political career started as a violent, started his political career as a violent leader, but later realized violence is not the solution. Non-violence is the way out only. Okay. So president is Mahmoud Abbas. So PLO is a legitimate leadership. Mahmoud Abbas. So now this time I'm asking two questions and I'll expect those who have already attended the lecture in GS class should not answer these questions. So when both the parties accepted each other's stand, PLO agreed for peace process. PLO accepted the existence of Israel and Israel agreed for phased withdrawal and agreed to transfer the political control into the hands of PLO. This was decided way back in 93. Why this issue has not been solved yet? Second thing. Okay, first answer this question. Why this issue has not been solved yet? What do you think? What led to the deadlock again? What could be the reason for the deadlock? Why this issue has not been solved yet?
Because in 2007, the new government of Israel agreed to vacate Gaza and West Bank.
Very good, Rui. New government did what? Refused. They refused. Vacate. And Neha, you are also very right. Rightly, you have said one thing. Hamas leadership was not the part of this agreement. Again, till the time all stakeholders will not participate in peace process, permanent peace can't be attained. One thing. Remember, we discussed that failure of Indo-Sri Lanka peace accord. On one side, LTT was not the part. And second side, on the other side, ultra-nationalist Sinhalese also opposed the accord. Now, within Israel, ultra-nationalist Jews opposed this accord. We have acquired these territories through blood. This government is ready to give the control back. Arabs are still hostile against us. Hamas should lay down the weapons. Hamas is not doing the same. And on the other side, Hamas leadership refused to negotiate peace with Jews. So according to them, if we'll give the control back from these territories, Hamas will use these territories to use violence against Jews. So both parties, there was a lot of insecurity prevailing. So lack of trust or distrust or mistrust, we can say. So both parties were not ready to trust each other. Now, other than this, Hamas leadership projected the leadership of PLO as traitors or not, who to acquire power is ready to negotiate with Israel and West. So Hamas fighters and Hamas leaders are ready to use violence against the PLO leadership. Samjho. And Hamas is seen as a terrorist group by PLO itself. Now, for PLO, Hamas is a bigger threat or the state of Israel is a bigger threat? Hamas. So they're Sunni Arabs are threat for Sunni Arabs. ठीक है फंडामेंटलिस्ट हमेशा लिबरल्स के लिए ज्यादा थ्रेट्स होते हैं विद इन इंडिया हिंदू फंडामेंटलिस्ट आर अ बिगर थ्रेट फॉर द हिंदू लिबरल्स ओके टुडे ऑन द नेम ऑफ बीफ लेटर ऑन द नेम ऑफ चिकन एंड प्रोबेबली ऑन द नेम ऑफ अनियन टू इन फ्यूचर इफ दे विल पुश यू कांट ईट अनियन टू देन गार्लिक ऑल्सो अगेंस्ट हिंदू नोशंस एंड यू हैव टू You should wear JNU and wear these kind of dresses, which they are. So they will decide dress code and will use violence who will not follow them. Okay. So for PLO leadership, Hamas is a bigger threat. And PLO also sees Hamas as a terrorist group. Okay. Recently, the convoy of Mahmoud Abbas, he went to Gaza Strip to see the conditions of the, because at present Gaza is under the control of Hamas and only West Bank is under the control of PLO. So he went to Gaza to see the conditions of the Palestinians who are living there. His convoy came under attack, rocket launches being been fired on his convoy. He escaped unhurt. That's a different thing. So convoy being attacked not by the state of Israel, by whom? By Hamas. A political instability is there in these territories, and Islamic State wants to enter into these territories too. If Islamic State will try to make its presence felt here, don't you think it will bring Hamas and Islamic State? It will bring Hamas and Islamic State. So there can be a confrontation between Hamas and ISIS too. Yes, despite all our Sunni Arabs or not. Yes. Objective of Hamas is what? Political control of Palestine, elimination of Jews. Islamic State also hated against Jews, but their objective is caliphate. So it can lead to a conflict between Hamas and IS or not? Yes. Now Sunni Palestinian Arabs who are right now fighting for Hamas probably could have thought of joining Islamic State for their cause, as their aspiration is to have caliphate, and they are gaining more grounds in West Asia. So many fighters of Hamas decided to join Islamic State when Islamic State was fighting against whom? Shias. Samajh rahe ho? So if Islamic State will make its presence felt in Gaza and West Bank, it can bring Hamas in conflict with Islamic State too. Okay. So for PLO, Hamas is a terrorist group. For Israel, Hamas is a terrorist group. For West, Hamas is a terrorist group. Who supports Hamas? Hezbollah. Indirectly, Iran. So for Israel, Iran is a supporter of terror in this region. And if we are with India in its war against terror, India should cut down all ties with Iran, because Israel considers Iran as a supporter of terror in this region. If Lashkar-e-Hezbollah are terrorists, Hamas is terrorist, Iran supports Hamas, Pakistan supports Lashkar-e-Hezbollah, state-sponsored terrorism, we are with India on the issue of terrorism. We have always supported India on the issue of terrorism. Anti-terrorism drives, we are cooperating with each other to counter terrorism in your region. You should support us to counter terrorism in West Asia, cut down all ties with Iran. This is the expectation of the state of Israel. But Iran is a strategic partner of India, and you will understand the importance of Iran more when I'm going to discuss the geopolitics of Central Asia. Okay, we can't afford to isolate Iran. It will impact India. So for India, balancing West and Iran is becoming more and more difficult. How to balance Iran, Israel, and Saudi is a challenge in front of India's look West policy. As an ambassador, if you will be posted in West Asia, your challenge will be how to deal with three major players of this region, Israel, Iran, Saudi. This is one of the biggest challenges in front of India's LWP. Clear? Ha, Aditya.
Sir, so ye Hamas hai, ye to Wahhabist hai, Sunni Wahhabist. Aur sir, ye Iran aur Hezbollah, ye dono Shia.
Arab Unity. Hezbollah, Shias, okay. Hamas, Sunnis. But Sunnis and Shias together on the name of Arab world.
Arab Unity.
Iran to Arab Unity mein nahi aayega. Iran ko kuch lena dena nahi Arab Unity se, but Iran hated against Jews, Shia fundamentalist. Okay, Iran versus Jews, Shia, Shia fundamentalist. Okay, against Jews. So you can see Sunni Arabs are fighting with Sunni Arabs, and Shias and Sunnis are in cooperation. Objective will, so it is, these are not the wars of religion, these are the wars to acquire power. So it is power politics. Religion is a way to acquire power. I hope by this time you have understood this thing very well. No one is serious for religion. Koi nahi lad raha religion ke liye. Now, Islamic State in Afghan, is it has brought Taliban in conflict with Islamic State or not? The organization started by whom? Sunni Arabs. Fighters of Taliban are Sunni Afghans. And Sunni Afghans are joining Islamic State now, because they thought that Taliban has ready to cooperate with whom? West. And to acquire power, they are ready to sit with US, which we will never going to accept. Okay, will not going to accept this. How come our leadership can sit with the US and the West? So fighters of Taliban are joining Islamic State in Afghanistan. Clear? Okay, I hope now today you have a better understanding and the clarity of the geopolitics of West Asia. Tomorrow you will have, you will able to understand more. Okay, so we'll continue tomorrow. Just revise your lecture and we'll start from Oslo Accord tomorrow. Okay, bye, take care. Do you have any question to ask? Okay, we'll continue.